She woke also to fruit, frightened by beauty, given love, shy. In her so much blossom, the forest no one had explored, with paths leading everywhere. They left her alone to walk and to drift, and the spring carried her along. Her simple and unself-centered merry life became marvelous and castle-like. Her life resembled trumpets on the feast days that reverberated far inside every house. And she, once so girlish and fragmented, was so plunged now inside her womb, and so full inside from that one thing, and so full, enough for a thousand others, that every creature seemed to throw light on her. And she was like a slope of vines, heavily bearing. Here is the reading.
Oh, virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one. The Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son. And you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child will be born, will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is her..."